let's discuss about the asset side of the balance sheet, right, which is prepared by the company as per Schedule 3 of Companies Act 2013. Till now we have discussed the items of liability side. So now let's discuss the item of asset side. Now in this asset side, there are only two main heads, if you can see. Non-current assets and the other is your current assets. Rest all are the subheads. So how the question will come in paper, you need to understand and learn even that which item will will come under which subhead and the main head. So let's start with first of all non-current assets. You know the meaning of non-current assets, otherwise these are the assets which we have not purchased for the purpose of resale. We need to keep these assets with us for a long period of time and we want to earn revenue from it as well. So now non-current assets, the first head is fixed assets. Now fixed assets mean first head tangible. Tangible means land, building, plant, machinery, the things which you can see, which you can touch. Very easy to understand. All your ACs, like your furniture and all, will come under tangible assets. Next is intangible. Names also you know. Goodwill, patents, copyrights, trademarks, any franchisees, then any license, any mining rights if you have, any computer software you have. All these things will come under your intangible assets. Next is your capital work in progress. Capital work in progress means, suppose my business has started constructing a office building somewhere else for the new branch. Now that building is under construction, no, it's going to be our asset later on and will be the part of the company's capital also, but that asset is under construction, so I have shown its value under this head, that is capital work in progress. Then the next is intangible assets under development. Similarly, suppose I am working on a formula. I have not prepared that formula yet. So whenever, or suppose if I am writing a book, let's say, or I am developing a software, it has not developed yet. Developed ho jayega, then it will be classified as intangible asset, but still it's under development. No, the company is working on it, so it is intangible assets under development. So when it is tangible asset under development, we call it as capital work in progress. If it is intangible, then it is patents, copyrights, trademarks, etc., etc. That will come under this category. Then the next is, these are basically subheads, you may say. Then the next subhead is non-current investments. Now you know, suppose your company has purchased shares and debentures of any other company. It means that you have invested in shares and debentures and you are going to get your money after, obviously after 12 months, 1 year. So all such investments are known as non-current investments. Then deferred tax assets, again this is not a part of your syllabus, you need not to understand. Still if somebody wants to know, then that child can ask personally. And the next is long-term loans and advances. See, when your company takes loan from someone, then it becomes liability for the company. But sometimes the company advances or the company gives loan also to someone, right? For example, loan taken from Ram, liability. Loan given to Ram is an asset for us. So it's that. So whenever the company gives loan to some third person, then it becomes an asset for us. Like, suppose you might have seen that when we used to have landlines in our homes, so we kya karna padta tha, landline ko lagwane ke liye kuch aapko security pay karni padti hai. Ab obvious si baat hai ki chahe uska amount kam hota hai, but you are going to basically use that phone for a longer period of time. Hum use assume karte hain, to ye security deposit kya ban jayega aapka, long term advance. Isi tarah se suppose agar aap telephone connection kuch months ke liye lete hain, 1 period से less than, means 1 year से less than के लिए लेते हैं, then also you have to pay some security deposit, तब वो आपका बन जाएगा short term loans and advances. Similarly in our homes meter लगा होता है आपका, उस meter के बाद आपको क्या pay करना पड़ता है, security pay करनी पड़ती है, right? So that also comes under long term loans and advances. Then the next is other non current assets. So now whatever left, that comes basically under other non current assets. Example, as I told you this thing, ki aapke like, okay fine, I'll relate this point with this. Let's wait. So first of all, let's discuss current assets. The meaning is clear. The assets, the money from which we are going to realize within 12 months to theek hai, but now one definition has more, or you may say one point has more been added in this definition, that within 12 months it's fine, but the money or the assets which we are going to realize within the operating cycle period of the company, right? So here current assets are those assets जिनसे आपको money realize होगा 12 months के अंदर, it's clear. But if your operating cycle is of 15 months, then also if you get money from them in 13th month or in 14th month, then also it comes under the category of current assets only. So the first is current investments. It's also very clear to you. Current investments basically means the investments which are to be converted into cash within the period of 12 months. See girls, you have not done that chapter redemption of debenture. That one chapter that has been eliminated from the syllabus this year. Us chapter mein kya hota tha? Ki before or like before making payment of debentures, means before redeeming the debentures, jis date ko redeem aap karte the, usse 1 year pehle, usse 10 months pehle rather, हम क्या करते थे, हम किसी बैंक की कोई सिक्योरिटी बाय करते थे, किसी बैंक में मनी को एफडी के फॉर्म में डिपॉजिट कर देते थे. क्यों? ताकि उन्हें ये एश्योरेंस रहे आपके डिबेंचर होल्डर्स को कि इनके पास मनी है, अगर मनी की शॉर्टेज हो जाएगी तो वो इन इन्वेस्टमेंट्स को सेल करके उन्हें मनी दे देंगे. तो रूल क्या कहता था कि जितने के डिबेंचर्स आपने रिडीम करने हैं, आप उसका 10% कहीं इन्वेस्ट करो. और कब इन्वेस्ट करोगे? डेट ऑफ रिडम्पशन से 10 months पहले. गॉट इट? और 1 year पहले, 1 year प्रायर टू डेट ऑफ रिडम्पशन और 10 months प्रायर टू डेट ऑफ रिडम्पशन. एंड यू आर गोइंग टू सेल ऑफ दीज इन्वेस्टमेंट्स ऑन द डे ऑफ रिडम्पशन इटसेल्फ. सो इट मींस इवन इफ यू परचेज दीज इन्वेस्टमेंट्स 10 months बिफोर और विदिन और 1 year बिफोर, देन ऑल्सो इट विल कम अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ करंट इन्वेस्टमेंट्स ओनली. सो द नेम ऑफ सच इन्वेस्टमेंट्स आर डिबेंचर रिडम्पशन इन्वेस्टमेंट्स और DRI. सो DRI फॉल्स अंडर द कैटेगरी ऑफ करंट इन्वेस्टमेंट्स. एंड सिमिलरली देर आर मेनी इन्वेस्टमेंट्स लाइक योर मार्केटेबल सिक्योरिटीज. यू हैव डन ऑल दीज टॉपिक्स इन मनी मार्केट इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स. मोनिका मैम मस्ट हैव टोल्ड यू दिस थिंग. देन द नेक्स्ट इज सपोज लाइक यू हैव परचेज म्यूचुअल फंड्स or you have purchased shares or debentures of a company, but the time period should be less than 12 months. ऐसा नहीं होता कि आप shares और debentures purchase करते हो हम शायद long term के लिए होंगे. You can buy shares, debentures, you can invest into mutual funds even for less than 12 months. So even you invest in such sort of instruments, no, that comes under the category of current investments. Then next is inventories. Inventories, so you know what are these? Inventories are basically the goods, the work in progress, the raw material, the finished goods which are lying unsold in the godown on 31st of March. It includes your spare parts also. It includes loose tools also. It includes goods in transit as well, right? So all such things will be the part of inventories. Then the next is trade receivables. It basically includes your debtors and bill receivable. This thing doesn't need much explanation. Then next is cash and cash equivalents. Cash means which is already in cash, and cash equivalents means जो cash जैसा ही बहुत जल्दी cash में convert हो जाए. Cash is already in cash, but कुछ ऐसे instruments भी होते हैं जिन्हें आप cash में बहुत जल्दी convert कर सकते हैं. Like the money in your bank, anytime you can go to ATM, swipe the card and get the money, right? Similarly, you may say cash in hand, it's fine. Cash at bank, then some more things can come here like bank deposits, so we have discussed. Checks, yes, checks, drafts, fine, anytime you can redeem them and you can get the money back. Then similarly, balances with the bank held as margin or security against the borrowings. Then one more thing is there, earmarked balances with the banks. Please note down this word, earmarked, E-A-R-M-A-R-K-E-D, earmarked balances with the bank. Like suppose I have deposited some money with the bank. Why? Just to keep it safe. For what purpose? Purpose kya hoga iska? Suppose the company has to give dividend to the shareholders, then the company has kept some money with the bank so that company use kahin aur spend na karte. So this money with the bank you can take anytime and you can utilize it for this purpose only, that is dividends. Because you have not paid the dividend yet, now you have to pay it. So you have, you know, deposited some balance, earmarked balance means some which is equal to the amount of the dividends unpaid. Jitna pay nahi kiye, utne amount ke dividend ko aap banks ke paas rakh dete hain. And then this is your asset only because anytime you can withdraw it. And moreover, it is a cash and cash equivalents. Then the next is loans and advances. As I have already explained you, like if you have given loan to somebody or advance to somebody, but for a period of less than 12 months, then it comes under this category. Then the last is other non-current assets. Examples are very clear. Prepaid expenses, your accrued incomes, all these things are other non-current assets. There are many examples given in your book, like goodwill written off within 12 months. If it is goodwill written off more than 12 months, then you will go here. Then the next is advance tax. Sometimes you know what happened? कि companies अपने tax को खुद अपनी basis पर ही calculate करती है और tax को means income tax department के compute करने से पहले ही pay कर दिया जाता है तो उसे बोलते हो advance tax. फिर उस case में क्या होता है कि suppose जो आपने tax compute किया अपनी खुद की assessment के basis पे और जो income tax department ने आपको tax compute करके दिया फिर दोनों को compare किया जाता है. अगर आपका compute किया tax उनके compute किए tax से कम होता है then you have to pay some more tax. लेकिन अगर suppose उन्होंने जो tax compute किया और जो आप tax advance में पहले ही pay कर चुके हैं वो ज़्यादा हो जाए तो either you can take a refund or you can you know shift the balance to next year even.